A Wallace and Ladmo special.
Hi, I'm Johnny Basha. On behalf of my family and all Basha's members, I would like to express our deepest sympathy to the Kwiatkowski family. As a child growing up, every day I would hurry home from school to watch the Wallace and Ladmo show. Each day was a show filled with youthful happiness. Ladmo was a great friend to many children, and he will be missed by many adults.
Good evening. My name is Pat McMahon. And this morning, Arizona said goodbye to Ladmo.
Perhaps it needs to be asked, what is a Ladmo? Well, for the folks who don't know, he's the fellow with a one-of-a-kind face, made uniquely from some kind of Polish silly putty, it would seem. A Ladmo is a hat. In fact, sometimes there really wasn't any particular need to see his face. The hat was often enough.
And I asked him, I said, hey, lad, what is your handicap? He said, 2 under. I said, gosh almighty, that's fantastic. He said, 1 in the water, 1 under the tree. You know.
Pat, I need your help.
Good evening. It's really terrific for you to spend your evening with us. We are going to ask you to stay for the entire 2 hours, because if you don't, you're going to miss a lot of fun. And I said fun, I mean it too, because even though we are talking about the loss of one of our best friends and one of Arizona's best friends, Ladmo, we've got a lot of good stuff for you. Hey, this morning, by the way, we should acknowledge the fact that this is my other good friend, Wallace. Today, we really had a turnout at the church in Tempe.
Did you notice at the service this morning, Ladmo's grandkids each had a memento that had been given to them by their granddad? One of them had his top hat, one of the grandkids had the tails, the coat, and one had the t-shirt, somebody had the boots, and the other had Ladmo bags.
It's a great family, Kwiatkowski family. They're watching right now. And hey, we should acknowledge the fact that this is one of the most unusual of events in television, in that it's live, the way it used to be when you started the Wallace and Ladmo show in 1954.
It's great. Yeah, I love it. Who's directing?
I believe that it's Sharon Kelly, and I'm really glad you brought that up, because Sharon has vignettes and anecdotal appearances throughout this entire show. Now listen, it is a show, and we're talking about a show that spans the 35 years of the Wallace and Ladmo show, and so many of the contributions that Ladmo made to comedy. I don't think that Ladmo would want to have any retrospective, any kind of a reflection on his contribution to comedy and to television and to Arizona if it wasn't filled with the kind of things that Wallace and Ladmo and I and all the rest of the people who were involved with the Wallace and Ladmo show. And we've got a lot of cast members down here that we're going to be introducing later on.
Good.
I think it would be a great opportunity right now for us to go into what it is that we're talking about, because you see, some of you folks who just moved here don't have any idea what all the fuss is about. This is what Ladmo is all about.
It's Wallace, starring Wallace, Ladmo, and Pat.
How long have you been watching Wallace and Ladmo?
In a long time.
How long have you been watching Wallace and Ladmo?
For one day.
I want to tell you about this guy. You know he comes around. He's got a great big tie from his neck to the ground. You know he comes around here with his hat so tall. This guy's so nice. He'll go to birthday parties for shopping malls. His name is L. A. B.
Is this crowd what you expected today?
I was hoping it would be a little less.
Big draw, Wallace and Ladmo.
Yeah, sure, they are.
How does it compare to like a half-price sale? Are they a bigger draw?
There's more people here today than there were here for the Pope, I'll put it that way.
Play a little composition now, bringing something new to the world of music, entitled Let's Build a Birdhouse. Ready? One, two, three.
Hi, Jody.
Hi, Michael.
Hey, look what I found, a box of chocolates. I can't even pronounce this name. It's something like La La La.
It's something.
That's it, yeah.
Yeah.
You want some of that? Hey, it's no milk, though.
No milk, though. Hey, Ladmo, you want to watch the Jungle Book with me?
The Jungle Book.
Yeah. What's your favorite song?
Ooh ooh ooh. I wanna be like you. Ooh ooh.
Ooh, oh,
Walter, are you gonna be proud of me? I've been working on an invention.
What is it?
Ladmo's spot remover, huh?
Well, I'll be darned.
And it's really great, and it works, and I'm gonna be so rich and famous and everything else like that. It's gonna be fantastic.
That's fine, but you really shouldn't be plugging it on the air because that is a commercial and you should have to pay for it.
No, I just wanted to tell you what I've been doing, Walt. Wait a minute.
What?
You got a smudge on your tie.
Oh, and my new polka dot
tie? Yeah, here. Let me just get rid of it.
Are you sure this, huh?
This will work, don't worry about a thing. I put Ladmo's spot remover right on there and just spray a part right on and then rub it in a little bit. And then all you gotta do is just wait for a few seconds and before you know it, it'll just disappear and everything else like that. Your tie will be absolutely you. You.
You removed all of the polka dots with that darn stuff. All right, sir. The choice is yours. If we're going to make a bargain on big deal, you've got to decide which you want. What's in the box over here, or in the envelope? Our studio audience, what should you pick? The box or the envelope? The box or the envelope, huh? It could be a diamond. It could be a watch, huh?
No, the box.
He has chosen the box.
The box.
All righty. And let's see what you won, sir. Would you please scrape it out? It's wedged in there. A head of lettuce. About that. Isn't this fun?
I strive to bring you something different, unique. Well, here they are. The human bagpipes.
Okay, we've got some Ladmo bag winners. We're going to meet them right now. What is your name?
Emily.
Hi, Emily. And who's this?
James.
Hi, James. What's your name?
She doesn't know how to talk. Her name is Nicole. My name's Kristen.
Okay, wait. This is Nicole?
Yes.
And you're who?
Kristen.
You're Kristen. Okay, now who's that over there?
Charles.
Okay, Charles. And?
I'm a member of the club.
You're a member of the club?
No, my dad.
Your dad is, you mean the member, he's a Wallace watcher? And a Ladmo listener? Well, okay, I'm glad he's a member. And for you, we have Ladmo bags with all that good stuff. What do you think, huh? Is that good, okay? Yeah, that's yours.
I really love watching those old tapes.
Yeah, I like that little bit of physical action there from Ladmo. He was a very, very visual comic.
Nobody looked like Ladmo, ever. I never ran into anybody that had ever said, excuse me, aren't you Ladmo? And it was the wrong guy.
Yeah.
There was only one. Ladmo and the kids, you saw that from 1954 on. There was really a special relationship, wasn't it?
Yeah, he was great with the kids, and he never changed his focus over the years. You and I sometimes would be doing stuff for the moms, but Ladmo was always there for the kids.
I think that Ladmo was also doing something for the Pope in that one bit, where there was special recognition for the fact that that we outdrew the Pope, that Ladmo had more people at Park Central than the Pope did.
Yeah.
And the Pope wrote a very nasty letter about that.
Right. You know, I saw the kids with the Ladmo bags, and Pat is the fellow that came up with the idea for the Ladmo bag. Before that, the kids would take forever to decide which toy from the toy cottage they wanted, and we just didn't have the time sometimes. So Pat said, get a paper bag, write Ladmo's name on it, and fill it up with stuff and give it to the kids. That was a good idea.
And for some reason or other, the bag full of stuff became actually more desirable in some households than Krugerrands. It was really amazing and continues to be. I can't tell you how many times a 45-year-old neurosurgeon or a corporate attorney comes up and says, you know, I've had a really good life, except I never won a Ladmo bag.
I'll never
forget the day that I was at the Christown Theater, and a little kid came over and sat in the seat that I was going to sit in, and that was the winning seat. I mean, people were holding grudges for a long time over those Ladmo bags.
What's next, Pat?
What did you used to say to Sandy Gibbons, though, when he was doing the...
Another phone call, Sandy.
And Sandy's watching today along with a whole lot of other people. By the way, watch it in the studio, people that you're going to be meeting a little bit later on, too, from so many eras of the Wallace and Ladmo show in this special tribute to Ladmo. Here's more right now.
Jerry, would you open the door? Get up. We gotta go. We're supposed to be on stage.
I'll tell you what. I'll get back to you. Just stay on top of the mark.
Come on.
Leave me alone.
Got your keys?
I got the keys.
I hate it when we do this.
Okay, so you got the straight, Gerald? No goofing around. With Roger Pass, I'll be taking the giveaway to Lambert.
You're telling me no goofing around. You spent your entire career goofing around.
There's no business like show. Business like no business I know. Everything the traffic will allow.
Why could you have that happy feeling
when you are stealing that extra ball? There's no people like show. People, they smile when they are low.
Yesterday they told you you were not so far.
That night will open and there you are. Yes, so
they were live at Channel 5, special memories of Ladmo. A lot of laughs tonight, right up to news time at 9 o'clock on TV5. Wallace, you got a friend. Lean on me, Kathy Dressbach. Sing a couple of choruses. Kathy Dressbach, Jody, and so many other characters that you brought. For how many years, by the way, those last few years?
5 years, the last 5 years of the show. Great times.
And doing personal appearances as Ladmo's other... associate on stage, because after Wallace stopped doing personal appearances and Gerald stopped doing personal appearances, you became Ladmo's partner.
The sidekick, yeah. We go out all the time and have lots and lots of fun. And you know, Lad never got tired of it. He had the energy and the enthusiasm for every single show. And after the shows, you know, he'd go out, always accessible to the kids, shaking hands and signing autographs and posing for pictures. You know, we used to do the birthday parties at the pizza parlors, you know. And I can remember after one show, going out and meeting the kids and everything, and this little toddler, I don't know, 2 or 3 years old, running to Ladmo, arms outstretched, looked like he had been submerged in a pepperoni pizza. And Ladmo, he doesn't miss a beat. He just scoops the kid up, gives him a great big hug, and just poses cheek to cheek for that.
Nice to see you, kid.
Glad you tuned in.
You know, there just never were enough Ladmo bags to go around, and you tried to explain to the moms and dads and kids about the fact that they were prizes, and Ladmo really wanted to give one to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
But 70,000 people at Sun Devil Stadium sometimes became a little unwieldy for bags. By the way, listen, talking about thousands and thousands of people, there was a 35th anniversary live performance at Encanto Park, special show. It turned out to be Ladmo's Woodstock.
All the way from Houston
Houston to see the Wallace and Ladmo stage show?
Yes, that's right. I was born and reared in Houston, but in 1968-69, I lived in Phoenix for a brief period of time and developed a very much of a passion for Wallace and Ladmo. I knew that this was the 35th anniversary, and about 2 days ago, it just came to me. I had my income tax refund, and I said, I'm going to blow it on this.
The show just appeals to all the kids. I mean, it has everything, and it appeals to the adults, too. I mean, like, Pat McMahon uses a lot of political humor that even the kids don't understand, but the adults still like to watch. My mom, I'm just like a second-generation Wallace and Ladmo fan. My mom used to watch Gold Dust Charlie when she was a kid, and I watch it now.
I like them.
You've been here since when?
6 o'clock in the morning. We thought he was going to be here at 9. And we were going to get front seat rows, and look at us. We're back here.
What are you doing back here? You couldn't
We've
get a front seat?
We've been around and joining in all the things you had around.
Now, this has got to be the smallest, littlest Wallace and Ladmo fan in the world.
Well, she's got a little brother that likes it, and he sings, and they just sit there and watch Wallace and Ladmo together.
Wallace has a real dilemma right now. He wants to know whether or not he should retire. What do you think?
No.
No way. He can't retire. He's got to keep performing.
How long do you think it should go?
Forever. Really.
What is it? The older you get, the better you get? It's like wine. You get a lot better as you get older.
Long before there was flower power, there was black and white, and there was Eisenhower, there was coming home after school. I'd eat some bowl of gruel sold by the shaky gray image on my TV. There were a couple of guys I liked to see. I was kicking back on.
Everybody having fun so far? Big fun, huh?
In 1954.
Guess what we have to do next? Who told you? Now, want this boo to be nice and loud. Let Gerald hear, because he's combing his hair back here. Gerald's listening.
Don't forget that G sus chord in the third bar. And oh, D. What do you mean D? I said G. Hey, listen. When we rehearsed it yesterday,
it's a good thing that this only happens once every 35 years, because I'm not sure.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the real sunshine of Arizona, Wallace and Ladmo.
For coming today, and thank you for watching all these years. We've got the most wonderful audience in the world. We love you.
Yeah,
thanks for
we
coming.
Love you.
I'm Karen Carnes. We hope you join us for the 9 o'clock news tonight after the Wallace and Ladmo special. You know, Ladmo was everyone's friend, and today, see how his friends said their final goodbyes. But the laughter did not stop. A special Ladmo tradition was carried out today. It put a smile on the face of the person in row 4, seat 2. The world of comedy also lost another friend, John Candy. We'll take a look back on his career. And Tanya Gate continues, but the roles are reversed. Apparently somebody attacked her. We'll see you at 9 o'clock.
There's a place where values remain the same. A familiar smile, a friendly face, and you know you're home again.
Weekly specials, double coupons, and bargain boosters all add up to good reasons for shopping at Bash's. But when you total up these numbers, well, we feel that's the best reason of all.
So no matter what...
him over to me. Kick him over to me, Pele.
He took one stolen car, two wrong turns, and a beautiful hostage.
You kidnapped me with a candy bar?
Makes a handy weapon.
Time to stop those little yuppie crooks, Bill.
Charlie Sheen, Christy Swanson, Getting There is twice the fun. The Chase.
This could actually work.
Rated PG-13. Now playing at theaters everywhere. 0 to 60. Straight versus slalom. A demonstration of who Lexus is relentlessly pursuing. The all-new Cadillac Seville SLS with the North Star system. Cadillac. Creating a higher standard.
Visit Coulter Cadillac, Lund Cadillac, or Kachina Cadillac today.
Washington apples. They're as good as you heard.
LADMO Remembered. A Wallace and LADMO special. We'll be right back.
Oh, what time is it?
Time for new glasses? All frames, even design, are 50% off right now at iMasters.
The cold and flu season may be winding down for humans, but that can't be said for your computer. I'm Fred Powers. Tonight, we'll show you a whole list of viruses ready to take you offline on the 9 o'clock news.
It's good.
Big difference.
Looks like it's more natural and homemade.
New Lewis Rich Carving Board Ham.
Carving board?
Like it's been carved right off a ham.
Totally new.
Delicious.
Switch to Rich. Lewis Rich.
Carving board.
I can't remember tasting a better ham.
There is so much dissatisfaction in spending your hard-earned money today that when people experience a store that is legitimately interested in their satisfaction, I think people respond extremely well to that experience. At the Men's Warehouse, you're going to find popular priced, branded clothing, brands that you have heard of, with the best service that you'll ever get in buying a suit. I guarantee it.
The Men's Warehouse in Mesa and in Paradise Valley.
It was a day they dared to dream of. A day when Charles Allen and his family would move into their very own home. It was a HUD home. One of hundreds HUD has for people with dreams, but not a lot of money. Some for as little as 3% down. Ask a real estate agent about HUD homes, because it's your turn to own a piece of America.
Ladmo, remembered with music and Commodore Condello. Ladmo was part of your Salt River Navy band. Hey, it's nice to have you here.
Hi, how are you? Interesting to see myself before I sold my hair.
A large number of European women are in the market for that.
Indeed. Indeed, yeah.
Sure is nice to have you over to remember some of these things. Music was really important to Ladmo, too, wasn't it?
Indeed. As I think I told you the other day, Lad, we went through a period where Lad and I would go to my house and write stuff and write songs, and it was the most fun period of my life. I would get to, you know, goof around with Ladmo, and we would just come up with words, and I would have a guitar out, and we would come up with these, with music, with stuff that we could do on the air 2 hours later, live. And Lad, of course, was so wonderful and so creative, and very musical for a guy who wasn't a trained musician. He was right there.
As Wallace proved to be, of course, with Michelle.
Oh, yeah. Mike was our music director for 10 years, as well as getting very deeply involved in all the comedy stuff. Now, all those stage shows and all those... say something funny.
Knuckle.
Yeah.
I came back from an extended leave protecting you civilians when I was over in Europe, and... it could have broken out at any moment on the Argonne Forest.
It could have.
I came back to the studio, and I'd been on the Wallace Show for about a year, and my National Guard unit was taken along with 2,000 other guys to Germany and France. So I came back. Wallace, having stayed in touch, said, "You're always welcome here." I felt like the young guy on the show. I got back. There was a 15-year-old. Condello, who was the music director for the show at that time, with Ladmo, and all of the stuff that you guys did together, and also Teen Beat, and a lot of the shows that were going on live, and sometimes in black and white, and sometimes just in black.
Yeah. Well, you know, I was asked to go to Germany as well, and I just didn't want to travel, and so decided not to.
Yeah, because the difference was is I was asked to go by our side.
Oh. Oh, that was it. Funny, that one little... Yeah.
What's next, Pat?
Actually, this is your introduction, because every 5 years, there was an anniversary show. And after all, 5 years is forever. So every 5 years, there was one, and the 30th anniversary... had all kinds of highlights, and we're going to be showing some right now.
Roll it!
Good evening. I'm Ken Kennedy, and if you recognize this character, you go back a long ways in Phoenix television, and so do I. In fact, that's me as Goldust Charlie. Now, I know it's hard to imagine, but a long, long time ago, there was no Wallace and Ladmo show, but there was a Goldust Charlie show. And back when he was kicking up dust, the character of Wallace was just a twinkle in Bill Thompson's eye. But of course, as you know, that twinkle has grown into an explosion that's been rattling this valley with laughs for the past 30 years. Tonight, we'd like to take you back through those years and relive a lot of that craziness. Let's turn the time machine on and go back to the year 1954. There's Bill Thompson at the age of 22. When he made his very first appearance as Wallace Need on the Goldust Show. You see, I needed a bit character one day, and Bill was a KPHO staff artist and studio crew member, and he said he was willing to give it a try. Well, frankly, Bill had been bugging me so much, I gave him a shot just to get him off my back.
Thank you.
Soon after Wallace appeared on the Golda Show, Channel 5 acquired a new package of cartoon features, and they needed someone to introduce them.
All the staff announcers turned the job down because they were afraid it would hurt their dignity, so I got it by default.
That was the beginning of a show called It's Wallace. By 1955, the Wallace Watchers Fan Club was formed. And if you were one of the members, you got a beanie, a membership card, and a newsletter. Now, enter one Latimer Walter James Kwiatkowski. Who, you say? Latimer was a graduate of Arizona State and the Sun Devil baseball team. But instead of signing up with the Cleveland Indians, he signed up with Channel 5 and worked his way into the studio as camera operator. Well, Wallace needed a sidekick one day, and Ladd was a willing accomplice. Now, through the miracle of 50s television, in living black and white, the character of Ladmo was born.
Well, what I used to do is I used to lock the cameras off, and then I used to run around the camera and get in front of the camera with Wallace, and we used to do our routines in front with the locked camera. How have you been?
Glad to see you. Where have you been?
Welcome home. How have you been?
Hello there. Welcome home. Hello.
Ladmo.
What?
What are you doing?
I'm shaking hands with an octopus.
Oh. Hello there. Welcome home.
How have you been?
Glad to see you.
Hello there.
Generous budget of $15 a week, Wallace and Ladmo continued cranking out old-time movies and westerns.
And this is the dummy that you carved? You made it all yourself?
That's right, Wobble. All the movable parts and everything, the face, everything.
And you've learned how to throw your voice to make the dummy talk?
That's right.
What's his name?
Oscar.
All right, let's see how good a ventriloquist Ladmo is. First of all, let's see if you can move his arm.
Oh, sure, watch this.
How about his head, so we can see what he looks like? Oh, boy, is he stupid looking. Yeah.
Shut up, Fatso.
Ladmo, you can certainly throw your voice good. I can hardly tell your lips were moving. That was pretty good.
Isn't it?
Yeah, all right. Now, let's hear you do a little song or routine with him.
Oh, well, I have some real fresh material, Wally. Brand new material. Never before heard of.
Okay.
So we have a little routine worked out.
Not the same old stock stuff you always hear.
Oh, no, no. It's brand new stuff.
All right.
Hi, Oscar.
Hello.
Say, I hear Max is in the hospital.
Yeah, that's right.
What's he in for?
About 3 weeks.
No, I mean, is he having an operation?
Yes, he is.
What are they operating for?
$300.
No. I mean, what does he have?
$250.
I mean, what's his complaint?
The bill's too high.
What's he sick of?
Operations. Max has had so many operations, they put a zipper on him.
Did they take his temperature?
They didn't even know it was missing.
That's terrible.
Wait,
huh? That's terrible. terrible. That's pretty good. Both of their voices are going at the same time. How'd you do that?
Now will the real Arnold Farnsworth please stand up?
What are you doing?
Hey, I'm Arnold Farnsworth.
I'm Arnold Farnsworth.
How could you be Arnold Farnsworth when I'm Arnold Farnsworth? Wait a minute, look
right here. Well, don't
Arnold
get shoved.
Don't push me around.
That is
enough.
That's
my name is Arnold.
I'm in the police car. Now, I understand that you're going into the record business.
We are going into the record business.
Okay. And we hope that you climb up the old charts there, and Jack Hurst has already given you a little mention in his column.
It's Fun-Lovin' Tarzan and Jane all the way.
Okay, and would you care to sing for us a little bit of your first hit recording? Hey, you're kind of cute. You need a shave, though. Okay.
Tarzan's going to break up this whole act.
All right, okay. Tarzan and Jane singing a little bit from their new hit recording. What's the name of it?
This is called the Tarzan and Jane Rock and Twist.
All right, that's the best we could do under the
circumstances. That sings and dances.
Okay.
Another scheme, that's the end of Little Rat.
Hey, listen, this is Ladmo Remembered, and we're remembering him with a lot of laughs tonight, live on TV5. Not only are you getting all this entertainment for free and being able to reflect on Ladmo over the 35 years, but there's no pledge calls necessary for all of this. I'm Pat McMahon. This is my friend Wallace.
WNP.
What's that?
What's next, Pat?
I'm Karen Carnes. Tonight after the special, we hope you'll tune into the 9 o'clock news because we'll have a little bit more about Ladmo, the man who made us laugh for 35 years, and his friends made sure the laughter did not stop today. Hundreds turned up to say goodbye to Ladmo, and it was easy to see how this man touched so many lives. Hollywood mourns the loss of another popular funny man. Maybe you've seen him in Uncle Buck or Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. And the Golden State isn't so golden anymore, at least for some people. We hope you join us for the 9 o'clock news tonight. See you then.
There's a place where values remain the same. A familiar smile, a friendly face, and you know you're home again.
Why are more and more young families shopping with a grocer that's been around for over 60 years? Maybe they've come to realize there's nothing old-fashioned about good old-fashioned value.
So no matter where you've been, remember that's just where you've got a friend.
The Olympic Games feature our nation's best. Now, your Jeep and Eagle dealers are featuring theirs during the Jeep and Eagle National Drive for the Gold Sale. Buy or lease Jeep Grand Cherokee Laredo at special savings. Buy or lease Eagle Vision. Get $300 cash back on Jeep Wrangler and great values on Cherokee Sport. So drive for the gold at your dealer now and drive away a winner.
See your Arizona Jeep and Eagle dealers.
You know, you might not be comfortable in this chair, or this chair, or even this one. But the nicest part about shopping at Perry's Consignment World is that you're sure to find a style that you're comfortable with. We have the largest selection of new and gently used furniture anywhere. Stop by today. There's so much to choose from, it's easy to get carried away. Perry's Consignment World in Mason, Tempe, Phoenix, and now Scottsdale.
My husband, the big football coach, well, sure he acts tough, but when he got the flu, I knew he felt it just like the rest of us. Body aches, fever, coughing. So I made sure that he got new Tylenol Flu,
Only new Tylenol Flu has maximum strength medicines and extra strength Tylenol brand pain reliever to fight even your worst flu symptoms.
Tylenol Flu really got him back on his feet.
Nothing fights the flu harder than new Tylenol Flu.
You know, he may be the coach on the field, but at home, I'm the team doctor.
LADMO Remembered. A Wallace and LADMO special will be right back.
I've got a little problem with my Saturn, you see. It's not here. You can't see it because it my son has it, in fact. I plan to let him have my other vehicle. I really didn't think he would take the Saturn because it's a four-door vehicle. But that was the vehicle that he chose. Right here you have two things I miss an awful lot, actually. My son and my Saturn.
Just one look. That's all it took, yeah, just one look. That's all it took, yeah, just one look.
Just one look, and you'll see stags filled with good things like real beef, tomatoes, onions, chilies, and seasonings. Just one taste, and you'll know how good stag chili can be.
Just one look. That's all it took, yeah, just one look. That's all it took.
Stag chili. See how good it tastes.
It's 11:30.
Diet Coke break.
Diet Coke break.
I don't want you to be no slave. I don't want you to work all day. But I want you to be true. And I just wanna make love for you. Love for you.
See you tomorrow.
11:30.
'63 marked the first season of the LADMO Jets, a sports team the three organized, helping to raise almost $1 million for Arizona charities. Hey, by the way, the 30th anniversary part two is coming up. Some highlights from that very special show from the past. But the sports memories that brought back to me, mostly pain. I remember pain in Globe, pain in Safford. I remember bruises in Bisbee. But we raised a lot of money. LADMO Jets.
Yes, over $250,000 over a three-year period.
Sports like...
softball, football, basketball,
roller derby, boxing,
and Chinese checkers.
It's time to tell you what's next, because what's next is memories of the team. We have assembled some of the folks who not only played those sports, but also entertain folks who do shows and go out and sweat and jump up and down and occasionally actually score some points. Introduce the squad.
Left to right, Mike Candela, Dan Moss, Al Douglas, and Mike's drummer, Rich Post. And there's Roosevelt Nettles and Gene Blue.
Roosevelt and the LaCords and Commodore Candela Band in part. And they not only played an awful lot of sports, raised an awful lot of money against the town teams across the state of Arizona, but they also entertained. That was before they actually had to go out and do bodily injury to themselves, like this.
We would like to do a song dedicated to the one we love.
Each night before we go to bed, my baby, say a little prayer for me, my baby, because it's hard for me, my baby, and the darkest hour is just before dawn. of the present, oh yeah.
To be loved.
To be wanted, oh yeah.
To be loved.
Is so much worthwhile. But say a prayer for me, my baby. Each time you think of me, my baby, because it's so hard for all of us, my baby.
And the brightest hour is when we think of all the blessed.
Time flies. Where were we? 1965. Hubcap cuts records, makes a number of appearances on Steve Allen. Marshall Good and Boffo the Clown appear on The Daily Show. Ladmo has a pal in the park, Harvey Trundle.
The Harv!
And the program is broadcast in color. That's better.
Balloons for sale. Balloons for sale. Balloons. Balloons. Balloons for sale. You tripped me, Ladmo.
Fell all over my feet. Oh, my toesy.
That's what you get. Balloons.
Balloons
for sale.
That's what you get.
What is this you've got here?
I'm writing a poem.
Read this poem if you can. Grudgemeyer's a mean old man. He's always sitting on my bench. I'd like to smack him with a wrench. Your bench?
My bench.
That's what I think of your poem.
You know what I remember growing up in Phoenix was Wallace and Ladmo. It was two characters that had a kid show on Channel 5. KPHO?
That's right. Wallace and Ladmo are now in their 25th year.
You're not still there?
Yeah.
You're kidding.
Oldest continuing entertainment team like that.
Yeah, I'm still there because I grew up with Wallace and Ladmo.
Yeah, still there.
They were my idol. I will never forget the day they took Stan Freberg's satire called The United States of America. He did the whole thing on their show. They lip sank to the record. It was great. It was just great. You believe that? I wore Ladmo ties down to here. I don't know what it was, but they showed the greatest Popeye cartoons. I'd never heard of Popeye before Wallace and Ladmo. They introduced me to a whole world of cartoons.
Mm-hmm.
And essentially, they were contemporary humorists. They never talked down to kids. That's what I remember most about them. They never treated kids like children. They always treated them as peers.
Now, they've been entertaining Arizona for a quarter of a century, and they're still at it. From KPHO, Phoenix, Wallace and Ladmo.
Thank you so much. I'm Wallace, the one with the derby.
And I'm Ladmo, the one with the top hat.
You know why we're here?
Yeah, to give away a Ladmo bag.
Yeah,
I brought one.
I got the seating chair.
All right,
right here.
You got it? Who's going to be the lucky winner tonight? All right.
Hey, this aisle right over here.
Here we go.
All right. Up that aisle there, to your left, the second row, the second seat in. Hi, Idaho. Hi, Colorado. Hi, New Mexico. Hi, Utah.
Montana.
That's the closest we'll ever get to being on the network.
I know.
We'll make the most of it.
Wallace and Ladmo.
I just want to thank the family. The family did it. They know who they are.
Thank you very much.
Got a petition here from some folks.
Petition?
Yeah, requesting two or more Roger Ramjet cartoons every day.
Two or more?
It's got a whole bunch of names here.
Wow.
Don Bandy, James Doty or Doty, Bob Lewis.
What school are they from?
Fuel Pump Lounge.
In television, they often measure our audiences by the demographic point, but I believe that was by the shot glass at the Fuel Pump Lounge. Listen, look what I found. Wow. Look at this. Al Douglas from the LaCords has this well-worn program from one of the Ladmo Jets softball games. This was before our uniforms were torn and tattered. Can you take another closer for that so that Wong can just take a look at some of the folks that are in there?
The LaCords, Mike Candela's band, Tony Evans, the disc jockey, Brian Donahue, and Wallace Ladmo and Gerald.
Wow, you were in such good shape. Oh, wait, inside.
Oh, my goodness, there's Aunt Maud and Harvey and Captain Super.
Yes.
And Gerald.
And,
good.
Right, and the other two, football teams and roller derby teams. And these programs actually were sold in the bleachers by a guy named Johnny Franklin.
That's right.
$40 a copy.
Yeah.
He got for these things. We never saw a cent.
Speaking of sports, I would like you all to meet now the fourth-ranked welterweight in the WBO, our own stage manager from our old show, Tony Escobar. Tony.
Good to see you.
Oh, you son of a gun.
How are you doing? How you doing, buddy? Yeah. Over here. Taking two.
Oh. Los manos de oatmeal. I'm telling you, it was wonderful to see you. Look at this. These are just a few of the faxes that you folks sent in saying thanks, Ladmo. And they're absolutely wonderful. They're poems, and they're sketches, and there are such special personal messages to all of us, to Ladmo's family, Governor Symington, with a special message of condolence for Patsy Kwiatkowski. Office of the Attorney General and Grant Woods wrote this beautiful story about when he grew up in Mesa watching Ladmo. Now listen, if we can we get a couple of these? This is like the Wallace and Ladmo show, how we're making it up, right? Baby Blues, and Baby Blues, Rick and Jerry are cartoonists from here, but they are nationally syndicated cartoonists, and they sent this in. This is especially, that's Zoe.
Hey, do you know, speaking of cartoonists, our old buddies Rick and Pete Kirsten are in the studio audience. They're over there.
And Rick and Pete Kirsten's cartoons, can you just go ahead and swing it around? Rick and Pete Kirsten over there. Rick and Pete having aged watching the Wallace and Ladmo show over the years. They were among the original cartoonists.
Right.
The
little bumper slides are that set.
Remember Nancy and Sluggo?
Yes.
Well, it's being done by Jerry Scott. Nancy and Sluggo, the national Nancy and Sluggo cartoon.
Oh, yes.
And Jerry Scott faxed us this.
That's wonderful.
Back in a moment. Ladmo remembered.
Store is celebrating the grand opening of our new third store in Phoenix. Get grand opening savings at all three stores. Save on this transitional sofa, only $297. This high-style contemporary sofa, only $367. This traditional sofa, only $397. Or this 100-inch Southwest sofa, only $467. It's the grand opening of another room store in Phoenix. Register to win in a $10,000 grand opening giveaway.
Put it all together and save you more at the room store.
I was minding my own business, breaking into this house when I ran into this dog. I hate this dog. I took those people hostage.
What are you gonna do, shoot me?
Go ahead, shoot her.
I hate these people.
Why don't you eat something?
Why don't you eat? Kids, go into the den.
And this lady?
We haven't had sex in quite a while.
What are we, girlfriends here? I hate this lady.
Is anything wrong?
The Red, rated R. Sneak preview this Friday.
Scottsdale Nissan, your low price leader. Hi, Art Piccinotti for Scottsdale Nissan, home of Arizona's number one selling import. Own a beautiful new 94 Altima for just zero down or only $149 a month. Or this brand new 94 Maxima for just zero down or only $179 a month. If you're even thinking of a new car or truck, remember, just zero down and only $149 a month at Scottsdale Nissan. 2 blocks south of McDowell on Scottsdale Road.
Caesar invented the aqueduct. Constructed the Colosseum. Imagine if he had created the chicken Caesar sandwich. New from Jack in the Box, marinated chicken, 3 Italian cheeses, and our own creamy Caesar dressing, all wrapped in warm, soft bread. The chicken Caesar sandwich.
I want the chicken Caesar sandwiches here.
LADMO Remembered, a Wallace and LADMO special. We'll be right back.
K-Lite does a great job of playing slow songs from Barry Manilow and the Carpenters. At Variety 104.7, we've taken out all the really slow songs and the meaningless chatter, and we've put in an upbeat mix of music from artists like Phil Collins, Amy Grant, and Eric Clapton. We've built a station that picks you up and makes you feel good. Variety 104.7. Try Variety 104.7, an upbeat mix of continuous music.
If you're taking the leading prescription medicines for asthma, ulcers, or high blood pressure, and you need a pain reliever, the one doctors recommend most is Tylenol. Not aspirin, not ibuprofen. Talk to your doctor about Tylenol.
What would happen if you took the relief of a liquid antacid and put it into a form you've never seen before? You'd get new Mylanta Soothing Lozenges. Liquid relief every time you swallow. New Mylanta Soothing Lozenges. My doctor said Mylanta.
0 to 60. Straight versus slalom. A demonstration of who Lexus is relentlessly pursuing. The all-new Cadillac Seville SLS with the North Star system. Cadillac. Creating a higher standard.
Visit Coulter Cadillac, Lund Cadillac, or Kachina Cadillac today.
Ruffles potato chips, huh? You suppose I could have one?
Well, if I give one to you, I have to give one to everybody else.
Ruffles potato chips, more taste, more crunch, more reason to get your own bag.
Reminds me, you may not have heard yet, but we got some very big news. With the help of the Attorney General, Grant Woods, that we were talking about before, because of his close association with the Boys and Girls Clubs of the East Valley, they did something for LADMO that has never been done, apparently, in the history of Boys and Girls Clubs, at least here in the Valley. In recognition of all that LADMO has meant to boys and girls, and his love for the Boys and Girls Clubs themselves and all that they do, all the activities. As of today, because we're live right now on Friday night, as of today, the club in Tempe is called the LADMO Boys and Girls Club of Tempe.
Oh, that's great.
And will be forever. And LADMO is very, very happy. That's special. Oh, additional news, by the way. This picture back here, as of this morning, on the news, the Boys and Girls Club announcing that said, and we're going to have a big picture. If we can find a big picture of LADMO, we're going to have it right inside the door, you know, so that everybody knows. Well, you got it, because you got that one. Channel 5 is donating that one to the club as of tonight. Yeah, we deliver.
Right.
My friend Wallace and his friend and my friend.
The last 10 years of the show, our writer was Craig Dingle. What do you got to say?
How much is this show paying?
Nothing.
But I'm not saying anything.
Craig was a major holdout, as I recall. What's next, Pat? We're going to have to acknowledge, we're going to have to acknowledge Dingle's contributions here, because there's people who have moved here and have no idea what a dingle is.
You saw him earlier in the show going...
And for those of you who didn't see him, I'll bet you're really laughing, aren't you?
Well, I'm not going to get paid for that either, am I?
Hey, this is fun, and it's fun primarily because of people coming back to say, hi, I had a good time with LADMO and the guys on the show, like the LaCords and Mike Condello and Rich Post. We really ought to acknowledge the fact, by the way, that the rest of the band... Commodore Condello's band, the Mike Condello combo.
Ray Traynor and Bob Dearborn.
Ray Traynor and Bob Dearborn. And we have a 35th anniversary tape coming up. Listen, you thought the 30th was hot? When do you see this? 5 years later, we aged.
Welcome to the Hall of Fame Museum. I'm Winston Wilkes Montague, Assistant Director of Archives and Antiquities for the state of Arizona. And I'd like to thank you all for joining me here for this historic occasion. On this date, April 4th, 1989, we commemorate the 35th anniversary of what is probably the longest running show in television history, Wallace and LADMO. Newcomers to our state might wonder, what's all the fuss about? But to those of us who grew up here, the Wallace and LADMO show is as much an Arizona institution as bolo ties and cactus candy. Many of us remember racing home from school to watch the show and wishing that someday, somehow, maybe we might win a coveted LADMO bag. Often imitated, but never duplicated, Wallace and LADMO were doing comedy 20 years ago that late-night stars of today are just now getting around to ripping off. Renowned film director Steven Spielberg was even quoted as saying, they were my idols. And so, we commemorate their 35th anniversary here at the Hall of Fame Museum with a special Wallace and LADMO exhibit.
Full I told you we should have gone to the zoo.
Fascinating memorabilia. In fact, I'd like to share some Wallace and LADMO trivia with you right now.
Who's he talking about anyway?
Who cares? There's supposed to be refreshments later.
LADMO has a giant LADMO bag to give away.
Yes, and you have a seating chart.
I certainly do. LADMO, would you hold just for a second?
I got two microphones now.
You never know who it is going to be. We'll find out right now as LADMO goes up that aisle right there.
Right here.
To your right.
My right.
To the third row.
One, two, three.
Whoever's sitting right on the aisle.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Alice Cooper! Hey,
35 years to get this.
And I remember you when you were the Spiders. Remember that, Coop?
You introduced us to television, and I'll never forgive you for it.
Thank goodness they did the break!
We're calling the clown dressing room.
It's Boffo the Clown speaking.
Boffo?
Yeah.
This is Wallace. I'm calling from the phone booth on the set. I don't think we're going to have time for you today.
You can take your clock and stick it in your ear. I'm on my way.
What is this? See the chocolate cookie. See half the chocolate cookie. Remember the chocolate cookie. Notice how I saved it by repeating all the lines?
Next time we do this bit, we'll get a smaller cookie.
Cassandra, what's the matter? Huh? What? Say something. Talk to me, Cassandra.
No wonder I love you.
I hate felt that talks.
And you can see a balloon right here that has lots of potential energy.
Potential.
And then you pop it on the side and lots of... lots of kinetic energy.
Do you know what it's like being a hero?
Hey, what's it like? What's it like? I mean, being a hero. Tell me, what's it like being a hero?
After all these years, finally, chapter 13, Ladmo over the cliff.
The Army drill team. Halt, one, two, halt! Line up, men. Please, this is embarrassing. There's a lot of people watching. Let's see how they respond now to their manual of arms. See how they take these drill commands. Left, face. That wouldn't happen if you had the rifle up on your shoulder where it belongs. All right.
Sorry.
It's very embarrassing. There's a lot of people watching. I gave you a big build-up. One more chance. Right, face. Ooh. The middle with you. Just put the rifle down.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean it.
Oh, no! Okay, Ladmo, let's mix them up. Please send in your card with your name and address. We'll put them right in here with the rest. There we go.
What is your luck?
Good. And the winners are Chris, Clarita, Carolyn, Schulbach.
It's been more than 25 years since that card was picked out of the drum. We called the number on the card and found out the Schulbach kids don't live there anymore. They grew up, moved away, and came back. Claire joined the Navy, went around the world. Chris went to school in Germany. And Carolyn went to school in Michigan. But when they get together here in the Valley, they still talk about that first adventure with Wallace.
The fact that Ladmo actually spoke to me made me feel real important.
You remained faithful Wallace watchers?
Yes,
for many years.
I started when I was 8. 8 seemed okay at the time. All my friends were doing it. But they knew when to stop. I tried to taper off, you know, to a few minutes every morning, but it didn't work. Now it's become a lifelong habit. It'd be different if I had kids, but I don't. Yesterday, my carpool arrived 15 minutes early and caught me booing Gerald. It was humiliating.
There is help. If you or someone you love is hooked on Wallace and Ladmo, dial 1-800-GROW-UP.
Would somebody please fix it so that the background is right side up?
I gotta tell you, Walt, Grudgemeyer was always one of my favorites. But I don't remember how it started. All of a sudden, you and Ladmo were having at one another on the set, and it was you as Grudgemeyer.
That is exactly it. Wallace and Ladmo were supposed to be buddies, and we were always getting into these physical things and fighting and that.
As Wallace and Ladmo.
As Wallace and Ladmo. Yeah. We were supposed to be friends, so we created the Grudgemeyer character so Ladmo could
get into a, you know, a rhubarb with him.
And then what happened?
We just kept doing it. I mean, it seemed to work.
Did people complain about the violence with Grudgemeyer?
Yes. And then we really started doing it.
Which tends to kind of be the spirit of the show, wouldn't you say, after a while? Occasionally, I drop in the fact that we're live here at Channel 5, and it's called Ladmo Remembered, because a couple of days ago we lost our good friend Ladmo, and today we had the funeral, and tonight we're having a party. Just recalling all of these things that I hope you're having a good time with, and I hope you and your family may be saving this one. I hope that you've got the tape in. For those of you who are real nostalgia buffs, well, here's a guy named Johnny D, who has spent a kind of an ill-spent youth collecting all of these things. Johnny, you just left the Grateful Dead in order to come down here.
To come down here. I wanted to come down and share some things that, I must say, first of all, we were talking about Johnny Franken off camera, and Johnny was a young kid who would come down to the studio and take some of the pictures we're going to see tonight, and indeed he shared, loaned me some of the pictures that we're going to be showing, and some of the coloring books and things are from his collection. And
Johnny's, what's the D stand for?
It stands for Dixon, actually, my last name officially. Nothing too mysterious about it.
Okay.
No, well, nothing.
Is Johnny Dangerous?
I could make
Johnny
it up.
Johnny Doom, you know, nothing like that.
Yeah.
Listen, you left Jerry Garcia and the Grateful Dead to come down here.
That's right.
Because this is important to you, and these are collected over years, so share them with the audience and tell us what it's about.
Well, actually, you could probably tell me more. I've kind of got some of the pictures recently, and some of these shots are new to me because, as I say, I just got them last night. Here is one of Walter Brennan.
And you know what? He never did many personal appearances, and we were really proud to have him on the show.
Reverend for Walter. I'll just kind of go through it. Here's a very young-looking Batman man with Eddie Hodges, who had the hit, I Believe I'm Going to Knock on Your Door.
Yeah, and I'll bet there's people right now digging for their copies.
Or burying, you know, I mean, just getting rid of them. Who knows?
Whatever this happened to Eddie Hodges?
Eddie Hodges. This is kind of the gang. It looks like after a Hubcap and the Wheels concert with Don Pietro there on the right-hand side.
Don Pietro is a disc
purple
jockey. Purple Pizza Eater on Chris, right.
And, that's at Legend City.
Mm-hmm.
Hubcap and the Wheels.
LaCords are in there.
And the LaCords. And who's that little girl in front?
Yeah.
Well, that's my daughter, Carrie.
Who is a terrific jazz singer on the East Coast now.
Nice eyebrows, by the way, Pat. I always love those. This was one of many groups that you may or may not remember, and they were called the Losers at the time. And Frank Fafara among some of the members there with the rest of the group on that. Now we go to some things that I enjoy the music part of Phoenix because there was such a great history musically. So I've got some vinyl. If you folks out there have these things up in your closets or in the attic, you might pull them out. This is the very rare Ladmo Christmas single. This is Ladmo and the LaCords on Ladmo Records doing Little Drummer Boy.
I played that on the radio the other day as a tribute to Ladmo. And you know what? People request that every single holiday season. Right. These are collectibles.
They are. I played it. I did the Christmas show on KZON, and we featured this. And, of course, the Wallace and Ladmo drive-ins are also featured there on the label. And,
ladies and gentlemen, that was seven plugs for different retail organizations in one single sentence.
Yes, but half of them aren't in existence anymore, so it's okay. It'll work out. This is the rare one. This is the famous Blubber Soul EP that features...
You know what? I don't have that with the music. Cover. I've got the music, but I don't have the
cover. Yeah, the cover took me a long time to find with Obese Man, Michelle, Shape of Things, and Run for Your Life, Little Brat on that. Now, some other things that also are worth...
Thank you very much.
Wait a minute. That's worth a whole bunch of money.
Thank you so much.
The least I could do.
Bless your heart.
The most? Steak at Durant.
Here's the Wallace and Ladmo coloring book that some of you may still have around.
And that was a production by what artist? Who
the brothers, those? The famous Kirsten brothers, I believe.
That's right, Rick and Pete Kirsten did that.
They Wallace did the artwork.
It was a kind of a rootin' job as far as I was concerned.
These are programs that Johnny Franken will put together for the various teams, and the Ladmo Jets featured in basketball, baseball,
we've mentioned Johnny
football.
Enough. No, we've mentioned Johnny.
All right, well, I'll do that. Bless his heart.
What's this?
This is the coloring book. This is the Wallace and Ladmo at Legend City coloring
Folks,
book.
Not only is the show not on the air anymore, but there's no more Legend City
That's
either.
Right.
And I still have my stock.
Yeah, I do too. I bought 100 shares. I'm still waiting to, get back. Here's something that goes back a ways. Ladmo actually had his own show for a while, which I would, you know, guys, a little more about the time of that. And according to the book, it was was in Arizona, Mexico, New Mexico, and other states actually ran it for a while.
You betcha. Listen, in Alamogordo, we did some terrific things. One quick picture here of a friend of ours, if you can get this, is a small picture in the lower right-hand corner. A friend of ours, I hope he's watching right now.
Yes.
Lou King. I had lunch with Lou last week. He said to say hi to everybody.
Well, actually, I believe that he was introduced a little differently than that, wasn't it?
Lou King.
That was Gary Peter Clark. And he was responsible for Wayne Newton being discovered in the Valley. So, Johnny D., we're grateful. I thank you so much.
Thank you.
And knowing that the Grateful Dead play just about one or two songs in a seven-hour concert anyway, they're probably just about halfway through that
just
second
about.
One. Thank you so much for
thank
coming.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.
35th anniversary, part two, thank coming you. Up right now.
What's the Johnny stand for?
I don't know.
Oh, I
and whereas... The Wallace and Ladmo Show has brought the joy and laughter to three generations of Arizona. Now, therefore, I, Rose Mofford, Governor of the State of Arizona, do hereby proclaim April 1st, 1989, as Wallace and Ladmo Day.
Wallace, Ladmo. Hi. Congratulations. The two of you were inspirational in the sense that I saw you and knew about you before I knew about Abbott and Costello or Laurel and Hardy. Then when I saw Laurel and Hardy and Abbott and Costello, I thought they had stole all their best members from the two of you. Call me when you're having your 60th, and we'll do the same thing.
You know, this is a historical day. Wallace and Ladmo have 1,000 times over earned this great record that has brought them to the Hall of Fame.
We are very honored and kind of choked up a little bit, because this is quite an honor. Here we go.
Once upon a time, Bobby and Betty wanted to do something nice for their mommy.
Oh.
They liked their mommy because she cooked the meals and washed the laundry and mopped the floors and sewed the clothes. So Bobby and Betty entered their mom in one of those contests that comes in the junk mail.
Ooh.
The prize was an all-expense-paid trip to Las Vegas.
Wow, all right.
Well, guess what happened?
What?
Bobby and Betty's mother won the free trip to Las Vegas.
All right, yeah.
Mommy left town in a hurry.
Mm-hmm.
And Bobby and Betty never saw her again. Occasionally, they get a postcard or a little something at Christmas. That was about it. And Mommy never had to cook the meals or wash the laundry or mop the floors or sew the clothes again. Not ever. Mommy was through with all that domestic drudgery forever. I love them family stories. No, this is a wonderful day. I only wish Harry Florian could have been here to see it.
Hey, it's Sergeant Harry Florian.
Hey, Harry!
This bit was taped about a month ago.
Right.
Try to make it look like it's happening right now.
Okay.
Harry was on the show for 9 years from the Phoenix Police Department.
Hi, guys. I mean, it's really good to see you. I wanted to stop by and just congratulate you on 35 years. That's just terrific. But I have a favor to ask you.
Oh, a favor? What?
Please, I beg of you, do not run that motorcycle tape.
Oh.
I've been humiliated for years. You gotta promise me. Please, don't run the tape.
Sharon, no problem.
No problem.
I'll just let the director know.
Yeah.
Sharon, you know that tape we talked about earlier? Mom, make sure
Roll it. Did he say roll it? Roll it. Take it.
Oh, here he comes. Here comes Sergeant Harry Flores of the Phoenix Police Department. All Michael right. wrote us a letter saying, I want a LADMO bag so bad, I'll suck jelly through a straw.
Yeah?
One, two, three, suck jelly!
Oh, my goodness. Come on.
He's clinging.
I see it going up.
Got it. The straw.
You have to empty the entire jar.
What? Give it, Tom.
Phew!
Here's your LADMO bag.
And you brought the lemon, and you mean you're actually going to take that lemon and put it right in your mouth and suck on it?
Without any sugar.
Okay, here we go.
This is it. Oh, the lemon's in there.
Your LADMO bag, Christine.
There's no sugar in this.
On the lemon.
No.
Your teeth are going right into it.
Oh!
Squeezing it.
Oh, look at all that juice.
Sour.
Go get him.
Justice Gordon, pleasure. Thank you so much for stopping by.
Pleased to be here.
And come back real soon. LADMO has a present for you.
Hey. A LADMO bag.
Thank you very much.
My LADMO. Pleasure. Hey, welcome really to our show.
Go say when.
That could be the youngest LADMO bag winner in the world in 35 years. 3 weeks old.
And there you have it, friend. To win a LADMO bag. I'd like to get an endorsement from one of the parents
good
for a LADMO
idea.
Bag.
Good idea. Yeah, yeah. There's a good supper. There. A lot of candy and everything.
What do you do for a living, sir?
I'm a dentist.
A dentist? Yeah. We'd like you to endorse this LADMO bag. Oh. How do you feel about the stuff in the LADMO bag?
Well, I think it's great. It's good for my business.
All right. There you have it.
Yeah, I told you guys that I'd get you in to see my Uncle Barry. Go ahead. Ask him.
I didn't really believe that was your nephew.
Well, we never talk about it much.
Thank you for letting us come to see you. We've reached a milestone. We've been on 35 years. We don't know whether to retire or keep going, so we came to you for guidance, for counsel. We need some words of wisdom from you on this matter.
Uncle Barry, how did you make those decisions when you were in Washington all those years?
Well, a very simple way. There. Stay on.
So, yes, the show will continue. And here's Channel 5 General Manager Dick DeAngelis with our new contract.
Okay, guys, all you have to do is sign right here.
Sign? Okay, yes, go ahead, Walt. You sign first.
Okay.
You're the old boss.
No, wait. Wait just a second. Get out of my sight. Listen,
Uncle Richard. You promised you'd dump Fats and Goofy and make it the Gerald Show. You promised me that every year.
I can't do anything that smacks of nepotism. I'm here to have the guy sign a new contract.
Wait a minute, hold it. Can you see that? What is Wallace and Ladmo, Wallace and... Where's my name?
Huh?
Wallace and Ladmo, what about me?
It's the Wallace and Ladmo Show, so it's the Wallace and Ladmo contract.
Wait a minute. And look at this. They make more money than I do. That doesn't. See what I think your contract
hey,
is. So much
Gerald.
For your contract. Oh. And so much for the attorneys. I don't care.
Oh.
Is it, huh?
Gerald.
Nice tie, bonehead!
Oh, my goodness!
We'll be right back!
Oh,
my goodness!
Mike. Jack Curtis is looking for you. All right. Thank you at home for being with us. Thank you here in the studio. It's not quite over yet because... Oh, I want to mention that Brownie Troop 1920 are with us today, and also Cub Scout Pack, what is it, 611? 619. We're glad you're here. We have time to find another winner, Ladmo.
I'm ready. So
just follow me. I've got the seating chart. And Ladmo, I want you to go up this aisle right here.
This aisle right here?
Up that aisle to your right, the third row.
One, two, three.
And whoever's sitting right on the aisle.
Whoa. Hey!
It's Ladmo's mom. The fix is in. Goodbye, everybody.
Oh, goodbye.
There's a place where values remain the same. A familiar smile, a friendly face, and you know you're home again.
Weekly specials, double coupons, and bargain boosters all add up to good reasons for shopping at Bash's. But when you total up these numbers, well, we feel that's the best reason of all.
So no matter where you've been, remember Bash's, where you've got a friend.
Since Toyota truck reliability and dependability are put to the test in America, Toyota said build them here, too. You know what? Most are. But the ultimate test is right here. Toyota 100,000-mile stores. Over 60,000 of them. And more coming every day. Toyota trucks. The reliability's built in. Toyota trucks. You just gotta love them.
Kick them over to me. Kick them over to me, Pele.
He took one stolen car, two wrong turns. And a beautiful hostage.
You kidnapped me with a candy bar?
Makes a handy weapon.
Time to stop those little yucky curves, Dale.
Charlie Sheen, Christy Swanson, Getting There is twice the fun. The Chase.
This could actually work.
Rated PG-13. Now playing at theaters everywhere.
I pulled into Nazareth. Was feeling bound half past dead. I just need some place where I can lay my head. Hey, mister, can you tell me where a man might find a bed? He just grinned and shook my hand. No was all he said. Take a load off, Fanny.
Ladmo remembered. A Wallace and Ladmo special will be right back.
I've known Karen Carnes for about 10 years. I'm real excited about working with her here in Arizona. We've always worked well together, but it goes beyond that, because we're truly friends. But I've got to be honest, it isn't easy being the new guy in town. There's a lot of expectations, and before I got here, people were telling me to do this or do that. But you know, the best advice I got was to just be myself.
Karen Carnes, Fred Powers, the 9 o'clock news only on Arizona 5.
What do you call that crusty stuff on your shower head?
I call it impossible.
Or that film on your shower door?
Uncleanable.
It's called Limescale, and now there's a new way to clean it. Introducing Comet Limescale Remover, specially designed to penetrate and dissolve limescale. You see, the minerals in your water can build up. Regular cleaners can't cut it, but new Comet Limescale Remover can, leaving everything incredibly clean. New Comet Limescale Remover. When others can't cut it, Comet can.
Hi, I'm Henry Brown. At Brown & Brown Nissan, we're still the one with the highest customer sales satisfaction, over 1,000 brand new Nissans for you to choose from, and easy to understand value pricing to give you peace of mind. Like brand new 94 Altimas, fully loaded yours for only $219 a month. Or brand new 94 Sentra XEs for only $128 a month. And brand new 94 Nissan trucks are just $99 a month. We're still the one, Brown & Brown Nissan, at I-10 and Elliott in the Tempe Autoplex.
There is a place where tall mountains rise to meet a sapphire sky and the untouched desert blooms with life. Where golf is second nature and desert indwellers are one. Yet you're just minutes from all the pleasures of Scottsdale. Here you'll find Rio Verde and the beautiful new Tonto Verde golf communities with championship golf and so much more. Rio Verde and the new Tonto Verde. This is Arizona.
I think he did a heck of a bunch for this place. He's really going to be missed.
And we do have Ladmo bags that we did save for him. And the kids used to laugh at me because I saved these things, but I'm sure glad I did now.
He gave back in every way, and I guess ultimately he truly just gave himself to Phoenix and to the children of Phoenix.
Sloppy shirts and the sloppy ties and the big top hat. I loved him.
You don't have a role model anymore like he was. I mean, he was really great for the kids, and they'll miss him, and I know they'll never forget him.
Their dynasty began on the old Gold Dust Charlie show, where Wallace would stop in and be a guest from time to time. And later, when the Wallace show spun off and Ladd joined the company, Gold Dust, played by Ken Kennedy, would stop in and be a guest from time to time.
He was our cameraman to begin with, first a floor man, cable slapper we called him, graduated to a camera. And while I was doing Gold Dust with Wallace, with Bill, he'd look around the camera and I'd see that face. And I told Bob Martin, our program director, I said, he should be in this side of the lens.
Ladd and Wall did over 9,000 shows and never a rerun. And about that many personal appearances for kids. One of those kids was Sharon Kelly, who grew up to be their director. Sharon won a Tootsie Roll.
The Tootsie Roll. I think I was about 5 years old, maybe six, and I was at a stage show. I won a Tootsie Roll. And Ladmo handed it to me, giant Tootsie Roll, this big. And I couldn't even talk. I was so excited.
Pat McMahon joined the cast, playing a catalog of characters.
You know, I mean, here's a guy who got to do what he wanted to do all of his life. He got to play baseball, and he loved it. He got to play golf, and he got to be a Ladmo, and he got to make little kids laugh. I mean, life doesn't get much better than that.
Bill Thompson was Wallace, usually the straight man, always the close friend.
It's sad because he's gone and I've lost a friend and a partner, and I think the whole state misses Ladd. There are three generations of yours. And
memories of Ladd. For most of us, those will never fade. Larry Martell, Arizona 5.
Boy, this is real fun. This is a lot of fun to watch, to be able to see some of those things again, and then also to see some things I don't remember doing.
You're right. Some of those clips, I have no idea when that was.
I have a question that maybe you can answer. The director of this, Sharon Kelly?
Yes.
Isn't she the one who actually went over the years and years and years of material? And she personally chose these selected pieces of material, right?
Yeah.
Why is she in this show so much? Every time I turn around, Sharon has included a Sharon Kelly bit.
I have no answer.
What's next, Sharon? As we near the end of just about any show, there's always the credits and the rolling credits, and we want to thank. But the people at Arizona 5 are just really terrific people. They've been good to us over the years, but they're really good people. And there's a kind of a basic reason, I suppose, why we have strong feelings outside of our association with the show. Because doggone it, for those people who have lived here for a long time, this was it. This was the television station here. And they're nice enough right now to be able to allow me to say thank you to Channel 12 and Channel 10 and Channel 3 and Channel 8. And if I've missed anybody who happened to run some stuff, I know that we were on cable, the news about Ladmo and some of the marvelous things that were put together by those other television stations, news departments, saying thank you in their own way to our buddy Ladmo. It meant the world to us. It meant the world to his family.
Republican Gazette.
The Tribune.
Mesa Tribune. And the radio stations.
The radio stations. As a matter of fact, I don't mean for this to sound like a personal plug, but I know that a lot of you were interested in hearing the radio show that I did Wednesday morning, shortly after I found out about Ladmo. And so KTAR is repeating it tomorrow afternoon at 1 o'clock on KTAR 620. There was one last show after 35-plus years, and there was no way that it was going to escape the same fate that all of the other 10,000 shows did. This was the last show, and it was still one of my favorites.
So much for tuning in. Here we go with the last. Oh, well, what the heck? I won't retire. How many of you were here for the taping of the 35th anniversary show? Yeah. Remember we said we'll keep going another 5 years? I lied. And I am retiring. I need to spend more time at the racetrack.
Yes. Say hello to Frank Chris for me, will you?
All right. But, hey, we have people to say hello to right here.
A lot of people.
I've got to get up here and see. What pack is this? All right. And what brownie troop is this?
695.
And thanks for the signs. That's nice. I like that. Lou King.
Hey, Lou.
Broadcast pioneer Lou King. And sitting next to Lou, the gentleman that's responsible, he's to blame, Ken Kennedy, the man that started all of this nonsense.
Thank you, Bill.
What did you think when we started out?
Well, I was on the first show. I never thought I'd be on the last, too. But I'm so proud of you guys. It's great.
And I'm so glad you're here. You too, Lou. I remember you were on way before us. You go back downtown to the Fox Theater in the late 40s.
You never wear a Ranger.
A first step of a Ranger. All right. Tone, what's next?
The World Tape.
All right, here we go. Whatever it is, looking back.
Egad, Ladmo, you've done it. You've created a monster.
Yes, I did.
It's coming to life.
It is.
The electrical current has worked.
Stand back, everybody.
Oh, it's so frightening.
I can see it now. Careful, God, I'll be famous.
Now for the real test ball, boys.
Monster, speak, monster. Monster, please speak. Speak to me, monster, speak.
Well, what do you want me to say? Now, here he is, our champ, back for the fourth straight week, Clyburn Krykowski. You look very confident, very optimistic.
Oh, this is great. I feel wonderful now. No more jitters or anything. I'm ready to go.
You're not nervous.
No.
You're not going to make any mistakes.
Oh, no mistakes.
No mistake. Go right ahead.
Go, here we go. Hey, hey!
I live in Phoenix, Arizona for over a decade, and I watch them every day. And I grew up, and I was supposed to be too old to watch them. I still watched them because they were very hip. They always kept abreast of the times, and they were very hip. They were the Saturday Night Live before Saturday Night Live. They were the Second City before the Second City. Okay. You know, and these guys were inventive and original, and they turned me on. They did a wonderful thing when I was a kid. They took Stan Freberg's United States of America, the album, and they did it. They presented the show one time on their local show, and it was wonderful. I remember buying the album after that and memorizing it.
Got to be kind of a void there. We're going to miss him.
Yeah, well, I don't even live in Phoenix anymore. I don't get the show. We don't get the show in Los Angeles. I'm going to miss him, but I haven't seen the show in years.
Just when you buy him, half a dozen of them, I go, oh, told him the cavity.
Well, sure, keep him in my freezer.
Oh, yeah.
That's where you got to eat ice cream, in the freezer.
Good, not great, but good. That's low in the sky without her. That's low in the sky without her. He's back, Mike Candello. Our musical director and friend for over 10 years on the show. Anything profound to say at this time?
No.
All right, Mike. I'm just glad you're here.
Yeah.
And there will be goodies after the taping.
Well, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Time to meet the crew.
The crew?
Ah! Oh. Yes. Come on. Ah! This is a show where we thank people. And the people that must be thanked are trusty crew. This is the varsity. The JVs are running the cameras.
God.
Tone?
Already mentioned.
Next week when the show goes off, lunch?
I'll check my schedule.
All right.
How about golf?
Oh, you got it. Right.
Okay.
Our studio manager, Joe Sampson.
There you go. Joe. He's a good man.
Mike.
Hey, Mike.
Lorraine.
Hey, Lorraine.
Rick. And this is our director, Sharon Kelly.
Hey, Sharon Kelly.
Now, Sharon's first run-in with the Wallace and Ladmo show was when she was a kid. She won a Ladmo bag at a stage show. And at that time, she said, I've watched your show, and you need help, and when I grow up...
She said that.
Thank you.
I love you.
I love you, too. No, I mean, I really... Somebody's at the door.
I'll get that.
Hey, Boffo the Clown! Bob, come on in here! Hey, look at that! The Clown, you're here to make us laugh! Candello's here and everything.
I hate hippies.
Boy, oh boy, what a way to act.
This I got a splitter you wouldn't believe.
A splitter, huh? Well, I got some news here. This is it, Boffo. The last show.
And not a moment too soon.
Hmm?
I've been waiting 25 years to take over, Ladmo.
Take over? What are you talking about?
Starting Monday, it's going to be the Boffo show.
Really?
Let me give you a little lesson in economics, okay? Management doesn't need a show with a dozen people on. All they need is one clown. Me.
Well, let me give you a lesson in economics. They don't even need a clown. All they need are cartoons.
What?
Yeah. See, starting Monday morning, right here on Channel 5, Bugs Bunny and Friends, huh?
What's that?
Well, it's cartoons without us.
Wait a minute. What about the Boffo show?
Oh, management had a good laugh over that one, boy. It wasn't even considered.
But what am I going to do?
Same as Wallace. Retire. Bye, Boff. Nice seeing you. Nice knowing you.
You haven't heard the last from me. Hold on just a second. There's no bye, Boff. Wait a minute.
Huh?
I don't need television.
Huh?
Maybe Boffo's birthday cake. I can work a deal with a bakery, I'm telling you right now.
Really?
Hey, hold on just a second.
Well, I grew up with them. I mean, I was born when they started. So, you know, I'm really sad they're leaving.
Now, you know, I was just thinking, this little one will never know who Wallace and Ladmo is.
I know she won't.
I watched them, my kids watched them, I expected my grandkids would watch them.
I don't think anybody could take their places.
Will you miss them?
Yes.
Just growing up with it, it's sad to see them leave.
Oh my God, I think it's sad.
Who is Wallace and Ladmo?
We've watched a lot of changes in Phoenix, so we really hate to see Wallace and Ladmo go because they were part of Phoenix.
All the kids are going to miss them.
When you tune in the morning after December 29th, they're not going to be there anymore.
But sometimes they be there at night. They do.
Ready for our vegetable serenade. One, two, three.
I'm Karen Carnes. After tonight's special, we hope you join us for the 9 o'clock news. We'll have more on Ladmo and the people whose lives he touched. But even though there were some tears today, the roar of laughter was all you could hear. See why this final farewell was special for all who were there. Another man who made us laugh has passed away. He played the coach in Cool Runnings, but maybe you saw him in Uncle Buck. And what comes around goes around, or does it? It looks like someone attacked Tanya Harding. But was it premeditated? The news at 9 is coming up. We hope you join us.
Some people are pretty sure they're going to buy a Toyota Corolla DX until they find out the Honda Civic LX sedan gives you power windows, dual airbags, power door locks, cruise control, a tachometer, and a four-speaker stereo cassette, all standard. And the Civic saves you almost $1,900 over a comparably equipped Corolla. Then they tend to reverse their position. Opt for the Civic from Honda.
Pools. Once a year, we add something extra. A sale. Now through March 31st. Only at Shasta Pools.
The first time he went out, I made him take me to Chili's.
Oh, yeah, it was great.
We ordered the baby back ribs. Oh, they were so good. Tender baby back ribs with a spicy barbecue sauce. Oh, and those cinnamon apples. And afterwards, he did the cutest thing. He ordered dessert with two spoons. It was so perfect.
Cindy, that wasn't me.
I knew that. I was just testing you.
Oh, really? How'd I do?
Very well.
Good. I was worried.
Yeah, so was I.
At Pruitt's, we strive to give you more for your money. One of the ways we do this is by using our huge buying power to get the absolute best deals in the market.
Pruitt's has bought the entire factory stock of this overstuffed oak-trimmed sofa and loveseat. Right now, you can get both pieces, the sofa and loveseat, for Pruitt's super low price of only $498.88.
No one gives you more for your money than Pruitt's.
Get it from Pruitt's, and you'll get it for less.
Ladmo Remembered. A Wallace and Ladmo special will be right back.
There are those who like to live life in the fast lane. And there are those who like to take things at a more leisurely pace. Well, for more than 60 years, Bashas has been making grocery shopping just a little bit easier for both those kinds of folks. And pretty much everybody in between, too.
The Olympic Games feature our nation's best. Now your Jeep and Eagle dealers are featuring theirs during the Jeep and Eagle National Drive for the Gold sale. Buy or lease Jeep Grand Cherokee Laredo at special savings. Buy or lease Eagle Vision. Get $300 cash back on Jeep Wrangler and great values on Cherokee Sport. So drive for the gold at your dealer now and drive away a winner.
See your Arizona Jeep and Eagle dealers.
You don't have to spend $500 to get a quality suit of clothes. At the Men's Warehouse, you can spend $200 or $300 and get a comparable suit. I guarantee it.
Get it straight from Ricky.
What would you say to your father right now if he's watching?
Why do you constantly get back together?
How good was the sex?
Straight talk, straight answers. The Ricky Lake Show. Straight talk on your level.
Weekdays at 5, here on Arizona 5.
Well, I'll tell you, for me, it didn't seem like it was 2 hours long. And I hope that there were no slow moments for you at home. As a matter of fact, I really hope that these were some of the tapes that that you were looking for. So many folks are gracious enough to ask us when we're going to have a reunion and when there's going to be some more Wallace and Ladmo stuff on. That's the nicest thing in the world to hear, because, of course, the opposite would be, why don't you guys get out of town? So it's really nice to have this kind of an opportunity. And for everybody who didn't grow up in Arizona to have the opportunity to get to know our friend Ladmo. Ladmo was not just the zany rubber face sidekick. He was not just our buddy. He was not just a little league coach. He was not just a guy who had an extraordinary gift making people laugh of all ages, grandmas and grandpas and their grandchildren. We have seen them over the last 48, 72 hours saying to us, boy, we're going to miss that Ladmo. Missing him, of course, most of all is his family, because he also was a family man. In addition to the professional clown that you've been seeing tonight, Ladmo was a very special family man, and I know that his family, the Kwiatkowskis, are watching right now. And today, when we had a gathering after the funeral, they specifically asked me if, on behalf of Patsy, his splendid wife, and his children, Kim and Robin and Jamie and Debbie and Sharon.
And his mom.
And his mom, Mrs. Kwiatkowski, who made the best kruszczykis and the best gołąbki's in the world. Those are the only two Polish words that I ever learned from Ladmo, because they tasted so good. The whole family and the grandchildren, they wanted me on behalf of them to thank all of you. To thank you who watched over the years, to thank you who have, in the words of the family members themselves, completely overwhelmed them with love and affection and notes and flowers and donations at their request to the Ladmo Boys and Girls Club of Tempe. So on behalf of the Kwiatkowskis, this Irish kid says, thank you very, very much. It's been an amazing friendship for all of us, and with you, my friend.
Well, thank you, Patrick.
You got about 15 seconds to tell me and everybody else, what was Ladmo really like?
He was my buddy. Goodbye now.
Christmas Day. Yes, it seems so very far away,
but it looks as though it's here to stay.
Oh, where is Santa Claus?
Suddenly,
presents neath the Christmas tree. Oh, Santa came to visit me. Well, I got a bike
and a train.
Now we can. can play. I said peace on earth.
Now I long for Christmas Day.
Christmas Day. Yes, it seems so very far away, but it looks as though it's here to stay.
Here comes Ladmo with the very last Ladmo bag to be given away. How many have you given away?
Oh, about 300,000 Ladmo bags. And this is the last Ladmo bag to be given away, and I want to give it to my good buddy and my good friend for 36 years, Wallace! Hey! He never won a Ladmo bag. This is your Ladmo bag.
I get it.
Yes, thank you, old boy.
Yeah,
you're my buddy.
And I